So today's topic is GTS NX getting started training according to our new campaign. So today we will follow up basic topics regarding modeling, which in our opinion is the most important part during the modeling process for geotechnical applications. So what is MIDAS GTS NX? Simply saying, this is advanced package which uses a finite element method to solve wide range of geotechnical, geomechanical problems, including deep foundations, excavations, complex tunnel systems, consolidations, and so on. You can also solve dynamic problems, and everything can be solved in 2D and 3D environment. But what is the biggest advantage of this package? It has a lot of really fancy tools which will be helpful for 3D. So MIDAS GTS is dedicated for 3D modeling. So in this spirit, please, let's follow up today's session. So before we will proceed with the contents I made for you, let me explain how to use our trial version. As Alex mentioned, we started with educational campaign, and during this period, all of you, you will get access for extended time period for testing. And what to do, what steps are required to join our campaign. So first of all, please look on the link above that I'm showing now to you. So when you click this link, you will be redirected to our page and account, a new account has been created for all of you. So you have to specify your ID, you have to set up your password, and give us your email address, because we will send you back pre and post keys and solver keys. Then you will use your ID to log in. Then you will click options button, and based on the information included in mail, you will set up the correct product version and click OK. So all of this support also will be given to you. If you cannot memorize this now, our technical engineer will send you a message and guide. Okay, so let's proceed with the training. So I assume that you downloaded MIDAS GTS now, and how to set up the product, how to start with the license. So basically, we have to go to the options. So there is the options button. And you have to go to the general tab and click on the license. Then you will get access to all of the options that I mentioned before, and you will be able to set up the product to run. Okay, so the next interesting and important from our point of view option is Snap. The Snap toolbox, which can be set up as the default. As you can see on the screen, we are giving the same options like you can find in AutoCAD, so you will feel familiar with our product. Snapping options are very useful at each stage of modeling, starting from the geometry sketching, but also including post-processing. So I recommend to review all of those options and pick the right ones which you feel comfortable. Okay, so that's all. And the next interesting information is related with analysis speed, is related with calculation time. So one of the most fancy features of MIDAS GTS NX is capability to handle all of the cores from your processor, as well as use GPU acceleration. And what is most important, this GPU acceleration is free of charge. So I encourage you to think about this, because it can really, really speed up your solution. So what kind of hardware is needed? Basically, we are supporting NVIDIA Tesla cards, but every card which has efficiency more than one teraflops in double precision mode, then it will be fine, then will be excellent. So please visit some pages like NVIDIA or Wikipedia, find those models, and you will find this parameter. I'm saying again, double precision mode, or double floating point. That's another name. It should be one more one teraflops, and then you will experience calculation speed up. How much? It has been presented on the next slide. So the biggest value you will see, the biggest value of this feature you will see when you will start to deal with 3D geometry and with the models with high number of degree of freedom. I'm talking about millions. So at the bottom of this table that I'm showing you now, you can find the last example, which shows close to 7 million of equations. And I was seeing much more during my experience in Midas, but that's the example that we were testing a couple of years ago. And when you are dealing with large models, you can speed up your analysis from 5 times, 7 times, depending how much of CPU and GPU will be combined. So this is a really fantastic feature. As you see, the comparison rate, if you take a look on comparison rate column, you can see that analysis speed up 7 times, but I have seen also 16 times. So this is really amazing. So how the process looks like in Midas GTS? I'm sure that you are familiar with all of those steps. I will not explain one by one. This picture is used just to show you how practical approach looks like. So in Midas GTS, we are starting from generation of ground surface tool. We can import the geometry. Then we are using some tools which will be helpful to edit this geometry to prepare for the meshing. Obviously, the next step is meshing, boundary conditions, and then we will move to post-processing. I'm sure you are familiar with this process. So how to begin your work? As I said, first step is beginning with the geometry. We need the geometry because it is the base for our future model, and especially for 3D cases. We can create this geometry by simple extrusions, and for that we can import from AutoCAD. That's the CAD software that you are widely using right now in your engineering practice. So Midas GTS NX have capability to import DWG formats, DXF formats, and both of them are supported for 2D and 3D. And the rest of the extensions are supported by industry standard interfaces. And if you are dealing with Autodesk products like AutoCAD or other products, you can also find STEP, IGES, Parasolid, or ACES extensions for direct 3D import. Okay, so previously was referring to sketches in 2D and 3D, and STEP, IGES are related with 3D. 3D models. So geometry can be imported. So this is how you are starting, and you will show this procedure many times during today's session because I've prepared some videos to watch. And the second way to work with geometry is simply direct creation. So what you can do, you can click on the geometry tab, as you can see on this slide, and you can begin your work from direct creation, starting from the points, edges. You can create solids, and you can use all of the tools which are grouped into separate boxes depending on the role and task. What is important for the beginner? I think it's very important to explain how topology looks like inside, what is the concept of the geometrical topology inside Midas GTS NX. So there is a table I'm presenting to you, and there is a graph which is also helpful to understand the general concept. Basically, we are starting from the point, then 2 points can be connected by edge. But what is important, those previous points are not disappearing. They are not converted into the higher topology. They are staying still inside the software, and I will show you on the next slide. Then from those edges, you can create wire, and wire is simply closed region. This region has no area. This is why we are saying wire. When we have face, face is a region with area, simply saying. So now I am at this branch. So this is wire and this is face. There is area included. Then if we go to the third dimension, we can create a shape which is called shell. And this is a closed box of the shell, so there is no volume inside. And when we are talking about solid, solid has a volume. So this is the highest topological geometrical entity inside GTSNX. We have also two things more, which is called compound and shape, but those entities, those features are used for, let's say, advanced modeling, but it's useful when we want to skip some parts and make one group to simply to forget about this. This is why it's a very convenient tool. We can create a group of the whole, all of the topological entities. So how it looks like inside the software. All of the geometry is located under geometry set branch. So you have to go to model tree and expand all of those branches. As I said, first topological entity is point. So you can see on the screen. Then we are creating line. But still, this point is present. So this is very convenient feature in Midas GTSNX because you can always back to the lower geometrical topology entity and do some modifications. So you don't have to start your job from the beginning. You can always back, let's say, one step before. So that's the example of the compound. When you are dealing with the geometry, you can also move them to different geometrical sets. So this is very simple. You have to create new geometrical set by right click, then include the geometrical entities that you would like to move and then apply. Of course, it's possible to go in opposite direction. So when we have solid or compound, we can explode this geometry to the lower geometrical shapes. Next slide presents examples. So if you want to extrude, if you want to create a basic 3D object, you have to have some profile. As I said, it can be wire or it can be face. Both of them can be used to extrude and create 3D object. When we have profile, we can use simple extrusion. We can use guide curve and use sweep option. This is perfect for tunneling. And that's the result. Moreover, we have a lot of options which allows you to divide geometries or trim in case of trimming the surfaces. We can divide geometries using multiple planes. And what is most important, we have also Boolean operations. Some of the operations are presented on the slide, so you can fuse, cut, empt one part inside another and prepare your geometry. So now let's take a look how the basic workflow looks like. Starting from import of 2D AutoCAD file, and let's see how to proceed with this file. So I'm going to menu. I'm clicking on import, and now you can see I will select the XF command, and I will import wireframe shape. This is also important. You have to check in your AutoCAD the settings. You have to export wireframe model, which means lines or edges, connected edges only. That's important information. Oh, I'm sorry for that. I just clicked wrong button. So let me begin again. So let's go to import. And now we are seeing import dialog box, and let's click on the select AutoCAD file. And let's see the sketch. Let's stop for the moment. So what we got here is a sketch from AutoCAD, as I said. And now by the colors, we have feedback that all of those edges are connected. So we are sure that there are no unconnected edges, and we can proceed with import. Also, there are other options, but I will back to them during the next video. So this is how we sketch looks after import. And now I'm clicking on the geometry tab and I will create faces. I don't have to do that because for extrusion I can use edges as well, but it shows the approach, and that's the point of this classes today. So now I'm selecting one by one, and this process will be finished very soon. So I can select multiple closed shapes. This is important. You have to select closed shapes to create face. Okay, it's done. So let's look on this tree, on the model tree. As I said, we have two geometrical sets. After import, the second one has been created automatically, and on the first one we have geometry that we created now. So now what we can see is it's geometry created by the user. Let's display model in 3D, click on extrude, and now I will create 3D model. I'm selecting all of the faces. I displayed global coordinate system, which will be used as the reference. And using option, which is called 2 points vector, I have to specify directional vector for extrusion. I will create 3D model. And that's the final result. Let's look on the model tree. As I said, we have two independent shapes. We have surfaces and we have solids. This is very, very important and very, very convenient in the same time. When you start to work with GTS, you will see advantage. Now I'm showing you all of them. Okay, so now let's proceed with another video. And this case shows the case when we are dealing with broken edges. So basically the procedure is the same. I'm going to import the DXF file, and I will import some sketch. Okay, so now let's focus on those options. As you can see, we cannot see color because those edges are not giving the closed shapes, which can be recognized by the GTSNX. Instead, we have feedback like there are some interconnected edges, and this is why we can see those indicators. But what we cannot see broken edges, because the unconnected edge means there is a small gap between them. But broken edge is edge which has multiple points. Okay, so let's see how to find broken edges. So go to face edge. This is what I'm presenting now. I stop the video, and there is a tab which is called manual, and there is option show height vertexes. Yeah. Oh, and now we can see all of the points from the edges, and we can start to think if model requires modification. In my opinion, in terms of 3D, it's necessary to clean some of them. Now I'm showing you which part should be modified, and I will tell you why. Basically, our goal is to predict meshing. So when we are dealing with geometry, we have to think about meshing. So those broken edges will create additional edges on your 3D geometry, and then this effect can lead to some difficulties, because we can get unnecessary element concentrations at specific areas. So now I will extrude this geometry. Interesting thing is, take a look on the length. There is 10,000 meters. So GTS supports very large geometries. So the scale which our geometrical kernel uses is high. So the range is like kilometers. Okay. And this is exact result that I was telling you. There was a broken edge. So after extrusion, I created a face which is divided, which is splitted. And I would like to avoid this. So how to do that? Procedure is very simple. Let me hide all of solids. Later I will delete them. We have to go back to modeling to the stage when we are dealing with the curves. And there is option which is called merge curve. I will go to the geometry tab and I will fix. Merge curve, and I'm selecting three edges here, apply, there is a tolerance. Two edges there and some of the edges from this part. So now it's also more convenient to select to create face because the number of the edges is smaller. I'm deleting previous geometries just to check how many points are available now. So you see it has been improved. So when after creation of the faces, I can extrude all of them. And my problem disappeared. Once again, 10,000 meters, click OK, and that's my final result. So basically, I clean my geometry at this stage. I can remove those edges later as well, but this is important because depending on the model, you can also deal with piles, and you have to check how many edges has been imported. Okay. And now let's go to another model and let's look how to prepare geometry for 3D excavation model. And the main aim of this presentation is to present how to use all of the comments to create that shape. So I will pre-play next video. Okay, so let's click on OK. Now I'm moving my work plane. As you can see on the picture on the screen, my work plane is aligned with zeta and x axis. And now I will move to x and y. So I'm selecting the plane. And Midas GTS NX has a feature which is called datum plane. And I'm selecting this x, y. So I don't have to specify some points, but it's also possible. And then let's start the job. I clicked on the point. So point can be created via a direct input, or we can read coordinates from the file. So I presenting this approach now. So location of the piles. As you see, table with coordinates has been imported. And all of those points will go under geometric set number one. So now we can see kind of cloud of the points. And now I will sketch geometry. So I'm clicking at the center. And now I'm specifying relative coordinates for the second point. So I created this rectangle via two points. There is always method and there is a tip for you how to create the geometry. So in my case, this one was selected. So firstly, I was clicking on at the 0, 0 point, and then second point has been defined via relative coordinates. And now I'm doing the same. So now I will specify coordinates for first point, 18 meters, for X, for Y, 21. And data for opposite corner, and that's all. So that's the geometry I started to work with. Okay, so now let's play with 3D. So go to extrude. Now I'm using selection filter, so that's the place at the top of your work plane, selection filter. we put attention to this part as well, because this is very convenient set of the box. So now I'm changing to the point. I'm selecting all of the points, and I will create lines by extrusion. Okay, so let's see how to do that. I selected all of the points. Now, regarding a global coordinate system, I'm checking only zeta direction, and I'm specifying the length. Okay, preview, we can check direction and length, and I have curves. Okay, and the next stage, the next step is to create solids. I'm not creating faces now. As I told you, we can create from faces or from the edges. It's up to you what is more convenient during your modeling. Okay, so the box has been created, and at this moment I can use face which has been which belongs to the solid and create another extrusion. Okay, so I created this one. I'm doing the same. I'm clicking face. I'm changing the length, and now I get feedback about there is no selected direction. Okay, let's fix this situation. Now let's click on the normal to propel and click on apply. Once again, normal to profile, and again. Okay, so I created this part. This geometry will represent layers for excavation. And now I'm creating solid stratum. First, second, and the final one. Okay, so now what do we have? We have a situation when one geometry is inside the second one, so I have to separate them. Yes, I have to go to geometrical tool and use divide operation or Boolean operation. So in my case, I think the most convenient operation will be divide. So solid divide. First of all, select target solids, and I will select all stratum. Then select tool surfaces, and I will select all of surfaces from excavation part. Now I displayed model with the edges, and I'm selecting all of the faces from this area. Okay, let's change the shading, and now I will show you the result. So now geometry has been put inside the volume correctly. Okay, this is the general procedure. It's really, really fast. Without my comment, it takes only 2 minutes. Okay, we can change the color, and geometry is ready. There is a question, so soon it will be there will be answer soon. Okay, so the next step is related with generation of 3D topography layers and boreholes. So that's we have two fancy features which allows you to create ground surface from the map, and you can use also a comment tool which is called Bedding Plane Wizard to create a stratum through the actual field data. So let's take a look how to do that. That's the next video. So let's begin with import, this time 3D, boring data, and let's hide unnecessary edges. Now you can see five locations for your boreholes, and let's create a geometry based on that. So first, click on bedding plane. So we have tool which will speed up creation. First of all, I'm not presenting this, but we have to create, we have to define how many layers will be included in your stratum. So it has been, the procedure is very simple. So you can click on add and define how many strata will be used. So in my case, there are three. Then we are inserting the plane name, 3D strata, and we can give the names for boreholes. So now I'm setting information for borehole number one, and I'm creating the depth for each of stratum for the borehole one. Okay, so that's the first point, first depth, second and third one. And that's the second location. So that's the snapping point. So if you click on this circle, the point will be automatically loaded, and then you have to create bedding plane. Then when you finish with all of boreholes, we have five boreholes. So we are given data for the depth for each of them. Then we have to create a bounding box. So this is why I'm specifying distance for X and Y axis. Let's click on preview, and that's the final result. So 150 meters along X and 200 meters along Y axis. Let's click on apply, and that's the final result. So software is using those points, and it creates approximate surface. Okay, so now we have stratum, and now let's create ground surface via TGM modeler. So we are using the same file. Now we are selecting which layers should be visible for the export, and now I'm selecting my terrain geometry, so that's the sketch, and I will go to the bottom of this window. I'm giving two corners. I'm specifying two corners to create the surface in general, so it can be little bit more higher, let's say, outside this sketch. And the final step is specifying the number of the sampling points, because this feature defines how much accurate sketch will be reflected inside the GTS after import, and how much accurate the surface will be interpolated. Okay, so there is a tip, like from 2 to 201, 50, 60, from my experience, is enough. So that the geometry which has been created, and now we have to save geometry in separate model file. Okay, now we are importing. And we have top surface. And now having the geometry we made before, like solid, we can follow up with a solid divide options and select all of surfaces to create the geometry we are looking for. Let's delete the top one and use random color. So it's really, really fast. Okay, another option I will just present to you briefly. If there is a situation where you want to create a node at a specific geometrical point, then this point must be imprinted on specific face. So if my goal is like this, I want to have node at this location, then I have to go to this option, select my target surface and select my point. And later during the meshing process, this will be taken into account. So this is useful for pile modeling, for example. The next option is related with mesh connectivity. So there is often we can face situation like our nodes are not connected. So how to avoid those kind of scenario? So basically we can check duplicates, and this feature will display which surfaces can recognize each other. Usually they are faces which are touching to themselves. So in my model, this is simple tunneling model with construction stage. Initially, software can see only four faces, and as the result, nodes are not connected. So how to avoid this situation? Just go to auto connect command during the modeling, and display all of the parts, select all of the parts, and use method which is called imprint. As the result, all of the edges from touching surfaces will be imprinted, and then when you check duplicate, when you use this tool, all of the faces will be recognized, and finally nodal connectivity will be assured. Okay, so we finished with basic geometrical modeling. So now let's go briefly with the rest of the steps. So Midas GTS NX supports many types of materials, a lot of material constitutive models, but basically there are four types of material definition. So isotropic material model can be created, orthotrophic, to the equivalent, and interface. So just briefly, for brief explanation, isotropic materials have the same properties in every direction. Using this definition, you can define properties for elastic, nonlinear elastic, elastoplastic attributes. Orthotropic material allows you to enter different parameters in reference to orthogonal direction. 2D equivalent linear model is used to consider nonlinearity and elastic behavior of the materials. In terms of 3D, and it's used for dynamic analysis, and interface and pile model describes frictional phenomena, and I will back to this definition later. So this is how we are creating material. If you go directly to the mesh, which is here, and click to the material, then you will get the material manager will appear, and when you click on isotropic material input, the default model type is Mohr Coulomb. And if you want to get information about all of parameters which are included in specific constitutive model, then you can press F1 button or go directly to this link, to this page, and then you can see our help and check the description of all of the parameters. So for the latest version, GTS NX 2019 version 2.1, we deliver 23 constitutive models. So now I'm showing this list. So if you expand this flyout menu, you can see all of them. And if there is a need to proceed with structural elements like walls, for example, then you have to click this checkbox, as well as you have to use appropriate model type. So inside the help, you will also get feedback which model type is can be used for which type of material. Like for the ground material, we can use mostly all of them, but for structural material, some of them, like camp clay, which is obvious, will be not appropriate. Okay, so that's the help. If you want to define porosity and describe by functions, you can click directly on this button or go to the menu and expand function menu. Then you will get access. Material definition step is also time consuming. So just to speed up this stage, you can use two convenient options. First of all, you can start with the model you made in the past. So you can create properties and you can create material definitions. And in new model, you can simply click on import, open the previous model file, and import material or property which you made before. The second approach is to use database. You can click on this button and review what type of material definitions Midas GTS includes. So I recommend this one because I think from practical point of view, this one is the most useful. So as I said, property and materials can be imported, but also they can be created manually. And for Midas GTS NX, we support one-dimensional, two-dimensional, three-dimensional, and zero-dimensional elements, which are called scalar elements. So one-dimensional is easy to understand, plane as well, volume, which are solids, and that's the objective of today's session. Scalar elements, these are elements like concentrated masses without dimension. So you can find all of them inside your property. Sorry for that mistake. It should be GTS. Also in Midas and FX, we can create the same. Okay, so this is how property looks like for some of the elements you can create inside GTS. Let's review one dimensional property. You can create pile, geogrid model for 1D, for 2D cases, for example, truss, beam model, embed beam, all of properties you can find here. Then we have following 2D, 2D elements. For solid, we don't have to specify additional parameters. Volume is given and is described by geometrical property of the solid. And this is why we are only defining isotropic, defining material only. It's isotropic in that case. Zero element dialog box has been presented to the left. So if you want to create links or springs, or if you are looking for other options regarding elements like free field for the dynamics, for example, you will find there. So mesh, as I said, can be created via properties attribute of the mesh. Let's start from this. And mesh inside GTS NX can be created via auto meshers and can be created from the bottom to the top, let's say. We have two automatic meshers. First one is called tetrahedral mesher. This is the standard one, but we have also additional hybrid mesher, which uses all of the solid elements. So on the next slide, I'm showing what is, how hybrid measure works. So as I said, we this measure uses all of available element types. So automatically it can connect tetrahedral with hexa by this pyramid element. So this speed up, this has a very high impact of calculation speed up since the model has less size. Okay, so in most of the cases we recommend hybrid measure, but for the complex geometries, tetrahedral will handle. But we have to also think about size, final size of the model, because construction stage analysis or nonlinear analysis will take a lot of time just for the iteration. So we have to look for some balance, and hybrid measure is very well suited for that. So some examples, geometry made by auto tetrahedral mesh, semi-auto mesh method has been used because I started to mesh with automatic measure for 2D, and this then 2D mesh has been extended to 3D. So now there is no geometry. I'm operating on the elements directly. The next one, you can create manually. So you can create element one by one, extrude, divide, and extrude to 3D, up to you. So that's the result of the hybrid measure and some of the practical model. So how the meshing looks like in practice for this simple model, it's really fast. Just go to 3D, set the size, select the measure. I will use tetra measure. Check options merge nodes. And that's the result. It's very simple. Of course, it's very simple when the geometry is simple as well, and there is no additional issue. So now what I'm checking, it was nodal control. I will go back to this option and I will show you again. So that's the node control. So if you go and click on merge, this is what I'm presenting now. And then if you select all of them, you can check exactly how many nodes are not connected. Usually that's the major reason why your model doesn't work during the calculation, and you will get error regarding singularity. So please check this. Okay, how to check mesh? We have also dedicated tools. Now I'm going to present you topological feedback. So we can look for feature edges. So if you are able to see contour like that for the feature edges and there is no yellow edge inside your model, it means it's okay. But it means only model is connected. Okay. And now let's look on another feature, on another model. And I would like to show you why work with Midas GTS is convenient. When we are dealing with geometry which has a lot of issues, thanks to this window that you have seen before, we can see which part of your model has some problem. Okay, so Midas GTS will give you feedback which faces are problematic, which geometry requires some modification or remodeling. So you cannot see this in other software. You can identify your problem depending on the part. Usually you can delete this geometry or explode, connect edge, so that there is a investigation issue. So when we are dealing with the mesh, the next step is also to check how many elements we can create on the edges. For that we have mesh control tools, and some of the options has been presented. So interval length and number of divisions will deliver equal division for the elements. There is a linear grading which will distribute proportionally depending on the size at the beginning and at the top. Hyperbolic tangent uses a function for that, so you can select those comments and create dense elements in the areas which requires this step. So mesh density control tools for automatic measure, we are clicking advanced option, and there is a slider which describes how much refinement has to be to use. So moving the slider to the left, the mesh will be much more dense. Moving to the right, you will create less elements. Additional option is called pattern mesh, very useful when you are dealing with geometries and you want to create some elements manually with a specific number of divisions. You are making some copies of the elements, you want to align some nodes with another part of your model, so I recommend to use this pattern mesh. Mesh check tool is also available, so you can display elements in terms of the topological quality. So there are options like aspect ratio, Jacobian ratio, so these define quality of the element regarding the geometry. So for example, tetrahedral cannot be too much flat, or ratio for hexahedral element like length to the height cannot be too high. Otherwise, for nonlinear solution, you will get high differences in terms of the stress. So keeping those values like that and trying to eliminate bad elements from areas of interest will assure correct results. And another options, similar to the geometrical options, we can create 2D mesh. Mesh can be swept. Elements can be offset. You can offset elements from the outside areas and create 3D elements. You can extract elements with some offset, up to you. Now I'm presenting a special advanced case when you want to fill in two shells by 3D elements. So you have to create closed domain. Then this option like 2D to 3D can be used and model will be fulfilled by the elements. So this is for advanced meshing study, not part of this training, but for the information, I think it's really interesting and you should know that. The next option, widely used projection. So when you have when you want to move nodes to some geometrical entity, you can select like from this line and pick the geometrical entity you want to extend to, and after projection the nodes will be moved. Of course, you have to look on check the quality of this of element after this step, but it's possible, and for small distances it will be fine. Elements can be also extruded between two complex geometries. So it's really advanced solution. And finally, a little bit about interfaces. This topic I'm sure will be extended during the next sessions. So basically we have two types of interface elements. Interface can be created for between one dimensional element and three dimensional element. So that's the case number one. So in case when we want to create excavation problem like presented on this slide, we can create frictional, we can specify frictional parameters and analyze frictional phenomena via pile and pile tip comment. For 2D, you have to click You have to go to create interface via this option. Now I'm presenting. I'm showing interface. It's for 2D pile, and pile tip is for 1D. So frictional effects between two shells and 3D elements can be assured via this option. So we have many options to create interface. I recommend to start with wizard, and after using this wizard, property will be created as well as material, and you can check what has been done by the GTSNX. So you don't have to think about what parameters you can use. You can operate with strength reduction factor and parameters inside this wizard data. Additionally, everything is described inside manual, so you can refer to that. One comment regarding what is interface element. We are saying interface element, but what this how it works? Let's explain this. So clicking on interface comment, basically model is splitted. So those nodal points will be splitted. Then, depending on the model, structure will be inserted inside, and structure and ground element will be connected via springs. And because of that, we can model frictional behavior. So this is how it works. We shouldn't merge those nodes, otherwise we will not consider interface. So we should leave it like it is. Okay, so that's all about meshing. And the next step is very clear, I'm sure. So loads and boundary conditions can be assigned to the geometry or meshes. And tools for loads has been grouped also depending on the specific analysis type. So there is no doubt which toolbox is valid for which type of the analysis. So it's very clear. The same regarding constraints. For beginners and for the 3D problems, we have special auto setting which can constrain model instead of you. Additionally, you will also go to the function in terms of specific boundary conditions like seepage boundary, or for dynamic problems later you can go and insert function. Water level modeling, also many approaches. We are starting from the basic one, which you can find inside analysis case dialog box. So this water can be modeled via plane level, and that's the input. Using borehole data, we can create surface, and we can convert this surface to create water level. And there are also other options related with the function. This will be shown during the next classes. So that's the example how to deal with the problem when we are, for example, with the excavation. So we can start with initial water level, and via function we can change the water level up to our need. So analysis setup is the one of the last steps, and many times we will use construction stage analysis. So when you go to this toolbox and click on the stage set, then construction stage manager will appear. And now I would like to show you what kind of construction stage study can be handled by GTSNX. So we can do stress analysis, seepage, consolidation, fully coupled, heat transfer, and fully coupled as well. So there are many, many analysis types. And for each of them, you can specify independent setting. Okay, so this is how your construction stage will be reflected inside the model tree. For the tunneling issues, for complex wizard, for complex problems, we can use stage wizard. So this tool will create stages instead of you, and also will be will be presented during the next classes if you, of course, request this type of training. Analysis control options. For the beginners, I just highlighted options that you have to check. So if there is a need to consider water pressure, then please check this toolbox. Initial stage conditions are already checked as the default. And for construction stage analysis, restart option is very useful. So I recommend to click on save all stages. Then in terms of issues with convergence, we can always back to the previous construction stage step and figure out what is the reason of this issue. So please click on this option. If we go to general tab, so we are here right now, then there is a general button, and via this Analysis Case Manager will appear, and you will get all of the available analysis types. So if you want to link previous construction stage and start construction stage analysis, just select this solution type and use previously defined construction stage step. So finally, when analysis has been done, we can go and start our post-processing. So results are loaded to the tree to the left. Then this result also can be exported to the table, and this table can be also saved as an Excel file. So that's the pattern that you can use. GTS is equipped with standard post-processing tools, so you can display contour maps. We can use probing tools to display value at specific points. We can display output distribution on the curves on the between specific points. So that's the cutting diagram. And this is how GTS interface looks like. I didn't mention anything, but what is the most important and convenient, the multi-window feature is supported. So in the same time, you can work with many models. You don't have to close your previous projects and start your work again. So some of the models can be still handled in the same time. Even if, for example, you start the calculation with this model, this model can be calculated and you have still access for next model. You just simply run the next session. Options for post-processing, clipping planes are available. You can display your model using the mirror feature. When you are using symmetry, it can be displayed as the full model. Isovalue surfacing is also available. So now let's take a look about post-processing. And I will demonstrate how to do that. So results are loaded to the left. And let's display results from specific construction set. So now I'm displaying translation for construction set number 2. And via the slider at the bottom, I can display results for each of construction stage. Let's display another one. This time I'm displaying normal stresses. And we can also animate. So for that, I'm clicking and selecting all of the stages, and I'm clicking play button. So you can see the changes. If we go to construction stage, we can also select and click on modify. This time I click double time and review the settings and result of your construction stage as well. So this one is useful when you want to check what type of loading or boundary constraint has been used for specific construction stage and see results in the same time. We can display the mesh edges. Feature edges can be displayed only. Probing, which means let's display value at a specific point. Nodal values, elemental values. Now I'm displaying bending moments. So what happened? There is as the default we have option which excludes results for different types of the material. So solid elements are hidden, and for the 1 second we were seeing walls. So there is an option which is called exclude. Excuse me. And now I will present to you how to click on it. Oh. So if we want to display results for the piles, solid elements will disappear. In the same way, when we click on a result which is associated with solid element, then this result will be displayed. On curve diagram, useful when we want to display variation along the length between two specific points along the curve. Excuse me. Okay. Let's reverse. Yeah. And let's click on OK. So now we see how the stress distribution looks like along between two nodes. Cutting diagram. Again, we can use geometrical edge. So before I was saying between nodes, now I will display solid geometry and I will select geometrical edge. And the same, we have to specify direction in terms of the global coordinate system and we can display. Okay, some scale factors also are also available. So we can scale those graphs. The next option, cutting planes. We can define cutting planes regarding global coordinate system, or we can define our cutting plane. So now I'm using this arrow to move my cutting plane to the position I like. And close. And finally, I will show you a tool which is called Export to 3D PDF. So I will use this model. This option is used to present your result to your collaborators. So when your client don't have GTS NX and you want to show to or send your results, you can go to export 3D PDF command and export results. So the only remark is this feature works excellent with Adobe Reader, Adobe products. So now I'm selecting specific results and I will generate 3D report and I will present how to manipulate with the data inside the PDF. So that's the result. So you can find geometrical sets inside your PDF. So it works almost the same like GTS, but without GTS. Yeah. Then you can display your mesh on the next page. We can see boundary conditions. We can see loads. We can display mesh groups. And finally, I will show some results. Okay, so that's the pile. boundary conditions. So I will speed. Also, some cutting planes are available. So this 3D PDF is really, really powerful. So I think your customer can be really impressed about this. Okay, so the same regarding post-processing. You can display maximum, minimum value. It can be moved. And depending on the property, results can be displayed only for piles or for solids or for shells, depending on your model. Sections. We can also specify measuring points. We can check the dimensions of our model. A lot of fancy tools for your customer.